sinners find mercy and the saints find joy. We pray to you for our brother Emmanuel, whose body we honor with Christian burial, that he may be delivered from the bonds of death. Admit him to the joyful company of your saints and raise him on the last day to rejoice in your presence forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Not
of St. Paul to the Romans, brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. According to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On behalf of St. Michael Church, I'd like to extend my condolences to the whole family and all the friends. My hope is that the Holy Spirit will be with you during this time of sorrow. There's probably not any words I can say to take away that pain. It's a lot of pain. But there is the work of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit comes to us to comfort us in our times of loss like this. We had today's gospel, this important gospel that said Jesus was sharing with his disciples. He was letting them know, "I'm going to leave you. I'm going to depart from you. But I'm not leaving you to be orphans without any help. I'm going to give you the Holy Spirit to help you in the midst of this." And the Holy Spirit comes to you in the middle of this too. But Jesus also said, I go to prepare a place for you, and he prepares a place for Emmanuel. There's an important place in the heart of Jesus for Emmanuel. He said, I come to comfort you, Emmanuel. There's a place. I am building a place so that you will know the comfort. For us here now, we're feeling the loss. It's hard sometimes, and it will be painful during this time of loss. But the Lord wants to comfort us in the middle of it. The pain will be there deep, but the promise, I go to prepare a place for you. Now Thomas says, well, where are you going? I don't know the way where you're going. Jesus says, the way is me. You put your faith in me, you don't have to know exactly how it gets there. You just put your faith in Jesus. I hope that you find room for Jesus to comfort you during this time of loss. That you will know the comfort that surpasses all knowledge, and it will guard your heart and your minds, that you will know he is your Redeemer, and he is the Redeemer of Emmanuel, and he is the Redeemer of you. Trust in him during this time. Let us rise for the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Emmanuel received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Emmanuel was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Emmanuel seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Emmanuel, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault had affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Santo eres in verdad, Señor, fuente de toda santidad. Por eso te pedimos que santifiques estos dones con la infusión de tu espíritu, de manera que se conviertan para nosotros en el cuerpo y la sangre de Jesucristo, nuestro Señor, el cual cuando iba a ser entregado a su pasión voluntariamente acceptida, tomó pan, dándote gracias, lo partió y lo dio a sus discípulos diciendo: tomen y coman todos de él, porque esto es mi cuerpo, que será entregado por ustedes. Del mismo mundo, acabada la cena, tomó el cáliz, y dándote gracias de nuevo, lo pasó a sus discípulos diciendo: tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de alianza nueva y eterna, que será derramada por ustedes y por muchos para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. el sacramento de nuestra fe. Así pues, Padre, al celebrar ahora el memorial de la muerte y resurrección de tu Hijo, te ofrecemos el pan de vida y el cáliz de salvación, y te damos gracias porque nos haces dignos de servirte en tu presencia. Te pedimos humildemente que el Espíritu Santo congregue en la unidad a cuantos participamos del cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo. Acuérdate, Señor, de tu iglesia extendida por toda la tierra y con el Papa Francisco, con nuestro obispo Alexander y todos los pastores que cuidan de tu pueblo, llévala a su perfección por la caridad. Recuerde a tu Hijo Emmanuel, a quien llamaste de este mundo a tu presencia. Concédele que, así como ha compartido ya la muerte de Jesucristo, comparta también con él la gloria de la resurrección. Acuérdate también de nuestros hermanos que se durmieron en la esperanza de la resurrección y de todos los que han muerto en tu misericordia. Admítelos a contemplar la luz de tu rostro. Ten misericordia de todos nosotros. Y así con María, la Virgen Madre de Dios, su esposo San José, los apóstoles y cuantos vivirán en tu amistad a través de los tiempos, merecemos por tu Hijo Jesucristo compartir la vida eterna y cantar tus alabanzas. Por Cristo con él y en él, a ti, Dios Padre Omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
Fieles a la recomendación del sábado y siguiendo su gran enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir: Padre, Cristo, libranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayúdanos por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles: la paz les doy, mi paz les doy, no tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia, y conforme a tu palabra, concédele la paz, la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes. Dense fraternamente en paz. es el Cordero de Dios, que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. Señor.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my bosom, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. your servant Emmanuel, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated, and I will share some words of remembrance that the family gave to me to share with you. Emmanuel Doroteo Tapia was a happy person with a bright future ahead of him. He was a strong, healthy young man, honest, respectful, sincere, humble, caring, loving, charismatic, selfless, and protective, and a very responsible human being. Emmanuel encouraged his friends and siblings to be the best version of themselves. Emmanuel was greatly loved and will never be forgotten by his family. One more.
Humilde y con un gran corazón. Emmanuel soñaba con comprar una casa y llevarse a vivir a toda su familia. Seguir trabajando, graduarse de una carrera y ser un buen ejemplo para sus hermanos, como lo fue hasta el último día. Fue alegría para sus hermanos. En momentos difíciles los aconsejó y vio por ellos. Emmanuel ha dejado unos recuerdos, no solo con sus seres queridos, sino también con todos los que lo conocían y lo apreciaban. Emmanuel, nunca serás olvidado y en nuestros corazones vivirás. Puedes llorar porque se ha ido, o puedes sonreír porque ha vivido. Puedes cerrar los ojos y rezar para que vuelva, o puedes abrirlos y ver todo lo que ha dejado. Tu corazón puede estar vacío porque no lo puedes ver. Lleno de amor que compartiste con él. Puedes llorar, cerrar tu mente, sentir el vacío y dar la espalda, o puedes hacer lo que a él le gustaría: sonreír, abrir los ojos, amar y seguir. Que Dios te bendiga y te tenga su santa gloria. Emmanuel Doroteo Tapia, que en paz descanses.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Yeah.
separate ways, let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Emmanuel in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.